Guten Morgen, es sind dann der Prof von Luxemburgisch with M. In this lesson, you will learn how to say in Luxemburgisch, I feel like doing something or I don't feel like doing something. Now, the key word to express the idea of wanting something in Luxemburgisch is Lust. Lust. Literally, this means desire or wish. But we will see how to use this to say I feel like plus an activity. Was du pratiert Lektion? Are you ready for the lesson? Dann los! If you want to say in Luxembourgish I feel like plus an activity, you have to use this construction. Ich lust plus verb at the infinitive. So t plus your verb at the infinitive will come at the very end of the sentence. Let's illustrate this immediately with an example. For example, to say I feel like going to the movies tonight is Ich habe Lust, den Abend an de Kino zu gehen. Now you see the t gehen comes at the very end of the sentence. Ich habe Lust, den Abend an de Kino zu gehen. How would you say I feel like cooking? Yes, this is Ich habe Lust zu kochen. Now literally this would be to cook, so I feel like to cook. But in English you say I feel like cooking. So Ich habe Lust zu kochen. Or we feel like driving or going to Paris for 2 days is Mir hu lust zwei Dich ob Paris zu fuhren. Mir hu lust zwei Dich ob Paris zu fuhren. Now, if you want to negate this sentence, if you want to say I don't feel like doing something, you will have to say Ich hu kein lust zu plus the verb at the infinitive. So let's repeat together. Ich habe keine Lust zu plus your verb. Let's have some examples. How would you say I don't feel like working? Yes, this is Ich habe keine Lust zu schaffen. Ich habe keine Lust zu schaffen. Or for example, I don't feel like waiting for you. Ich habe keine Lust, ob dich zu warten. Ich habe keine Lust, ob dich zu warten. Or, my son doesn't feel like going to school is Mein Jung hat keine Lust, an die Schule zu gehen. Mein Jung hat keine Lust, an die Schule zu gehen. Great, now you can say I feel like doing something and I don't feel like doing something. An easy and friendly way to make an invitation for some kind of activity is to ask someone, Hast du Lust? Hast du Lust? For example, Hast du Lust, madais an de Kino zu gehen? Hast du Lust, madais an de Kino zu gehen? Or how would you ask someone, Do you feel like coming at my place on the weekend? Hut dir Lust, the weekend bei mich zu kommen? Hut dir Lust, the weekend bei mich zu kommen? Or, do you feel like helping me? Hast du Lust, mir zu helfen? Hast du Lust, mir zu helfen? Let's see now how to make a sentence with a separable verb. A separable verb is a verb with a separable particle. For example, lernst kommen, heimfuhren, aufhängen, and so on. So then you will have to put the t between the separable particle and the stem of the verb. Let's illustrate this immediately. For example, Hast du Lust, heute lernst zu kommen? So lernst zu kommen, the separable verb is lernst kommen, the separable particle is lernst, then your z and then kommen. Hast du Lust, heute lernst zu kommen? Or how would you say, I feel like going or driving home now? This is, schulost lo heim zu fuhren. So you have the verb heim fuhren. The separable particle is heim, and then you put your z and then fuhren. Schulost lo heim zu fuhren. Next example with a separable verb. Schu keng lost mat zu kommen. Schu keng lost mat zu kommen. So here is the verb. Here we have the verb mat kommen. The separable particle is mat. Zu, and then kommen. Ich habe keine Lust, matt zu kommen. Great. Let's finish this lesson with another sentence construction with the word Lust. So in English you would say, are you up for something? In Luxembourgish we have Ich habe Lust ob plus a noun. So Ich habe Lust ob, you have to use this preposition ob, and then followed by a noun. So you will have a sentence without this infinitive construction. For example, are you up for pizza? Is hast du Lust ob pizza? Hast du Lust ob pizza? Or hat dir Lust ob a beer? Hat dir Lust ob a beer? Or to ask someone, are you up for a dessert? Or do you feel like eating a dessert? Is, hast du Lust auf ein Dessert? Hast du Lust auf ein Dessert? Great. The best way to practice what you have learned today is to head over to my blog, where you can find the full transcript of this lesson and download the PDF copy of this lesson. And in the PDF copy, I have inserted an exercise, a translation exercise with 10 sentences, which you will have to translate into Luxembourgish. And why not becoming a member of Luxembourgish with Anne? So to have access to all my lessons on my blog and to practice with all my exercises. Merci fürs Zuschauen. Thank you for watching.